सब्सक्राइब कीजिए आयुर्वेद इंस्टीट्यूट चैनल को और प्रेस कीजिए बेल आइकन को ताकि आपको मिल सके हमारा लेटेस्ट वीडियो सबसे पहले और ये बिल्कुल फ्री है।
हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आयुर्वेद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑनलाइन। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस रेलेवेंट टू योर बोर्ड एग्जाम। सो स्टूडेंट्स, डोंट स्किप एनी क्वेश्चंस बिकॉज ईच एंड एवरी क्वेश्चंस आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। दीस क्वेश्चंस आर वेरी सिलेक्टिव क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आई हैव टेकन फ्रॉम द प्रीवियस 5 ईयर क्वेश्चन पेपर। सो स्टूडेंट्स, डोंट स्किप एनी क्वेश्चन एंड स्कोर मैक्सिमम मार्क्स इन योर बोर्ड एग्जाम। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट आवर टुडेज क्वेश्चन, दैट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 29। एक्सप्लेन द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ द क्लींजिंग एक्शन ऑफ सोप्स। व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय सोप? सोप इज द सोडियम और पोटेशियम सॉल्ट ऑफ लॉन्ग चेन फैटी एसिड, दैट इज कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड। एंड द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ सोप आर सोडियम स्टेरेट and sodium permeate. Okay, and sodium stearate is C17H35CONa, and sodium permeate is C15H31CONa. This is the example of the soap. This is the hydrocarbon, that is it may be C17H35 or C15H31, and it is combined with COO- and Na+. So this is the hydrocarbon and this is the ionic part. Okay, and this hydrocarbon is the water heating, and this ionic part is hydrophilic because this is water loving. Okay, hydrocarbon part is also known as non-polar, and this ionic part is polar. Now remember these two things, that hydrocarbon part is hydrophobia, that is water heating, and ionic part is hydrophilic, that is water loving, and this is non-polar and this part is polar. Okay, how to remember that which one is hydrophilic? Because this is ionic and water is also ionic, OH-. So this is hydrophilic, it means that it is water loving and this is polar, and water is also polar, so polar will attract, and this hydrocarbon is non-polar, so non-polar will attract with each other. Let us take this as a ionic part. Okay, this is ionic part and this is hydrocarbon. Now let us assume that this is our bucket and there is water present in the bucket. Okay, this is water, and when we add soap solution inside this bucket, this is the soap solution. Then what will happen when we put the dirty cloth inside this bucket? Let us assume that insert the t-shirt having the oil drops in it. Now we have to remove that oil drop. How to remove it? So when we insert that cloth, let us assume that this is the cloth and this is the oil drop. Oil drop inside the cloth. Then what will happen? As I discussed that this part is the hydrophilic and this part is the hydrophobic. So hydrophobic part attract towards the oil because this is water heater and hydrocarbon, and this oil drop both are non-polar. So non-polar will attract with each other, and water and this ionic part are polar and this ionic part is hydrophilic. So this will attract towards the water. Okay, so this ionic end faces outward and the hydrocarbon part is faces towards the oil. Okay, and it forms like this. This is known as formation of micelles. So this is oil drop, this is ionic part. When we add the cloth having the oil drop in it, then the oil will attract towards the hydrophobic, and the hydrophobic part is the hydrocarbon, and the hydrocarbon is non-polar and the oil is also non-polar. So both will attract with each other, and this hydrophilic part, that is ionic part, will attract towards the water because this is polar and water is also polar. So ionic part will attract towards the water and this hydrophobic part will attract towards the oil drops, and it form a micelle. This is the formation of micelle. We call it as a formation of micelles. Okay, a molecule of soap has two dissimilar ends, that is ionic and hydrocarbon. At one end it is hydrocarbon chain, which is water repellent, and the other end is carboxylate anion, which is polar end. Okay, when soap is dissolved in water, then many molecules come together and form a group like this and is known as micelles. And these micelles are formed because the hydrocarbon chain come together and the polar ends are projected outward. So this will form a group, and that group is known as micelles. Okay, this is the oil droplet. Okay, and this is the ionic part, and this is the hydrocarbon part. Okay, this is the hydrocarbon part, this is the oil droplet, and this is the ionic part, and this formation is the micelle. This is formation of micelles. Okay, so this oil droplet is surrounded by the group of the hydrocarbon chain. Okay, so oil droplet is surrounded by the molecule of the soap. Now what will happen when we rub the cloth where the oil drop is present? Then the soap micelles helps in dissolving the oil droplet in water. By taking out this oil droplet from the cloth, and we can wash out cloth clean by this process. Okay, so when a cloth with a spot of oil soaked into a soap solution soaks, dissolves tiny oil droplet by a hydrophobic, and this is hydrophobic ends in the middle of the micelles. Okay, this is the formation of micelle, and in the middle there is the oil droplet which is attached with the hydrophobic end of the soap. Okay, due to the outer polar end, these mesas dissolves in water. Due to this hydrophilic ion, these mesas will dissolve in water because this hydrophilic ion will attracted towards the water. In this way our clothes get cleaned. Okay, now you can take a screenshot. Now come to next question, that is differences between soaps and detergent. Soaps are sodium or potassium salt of long chain fatty acid. Fatty acid is carboxylic acid, and the ionic part of soap is COO-Na+. That is, this is the carboxylic group. And the ionic part of detergent is SO3-Na+. Their efficiency decreases in hard water, and in detergent their efficiency is unaffected in hard water. It means that soap cannot be dissolved in hard water because hard water contains the calcium and magnesium salt. So the soap molecule will react with the salt present in the hard water, that is calcium and magnesium. And do you know what will happen when they will react with each other? Insoluble precipitate will form, and that insoluble precipitate is known as a scum, and that scum will stuck with the dirty cloth and it will not help to clean the cloth. But detergent molecule will not react with the calcium and magnesium salt which are present in the hard water, so the efficiency of detergent is unaffected in hard water. Okay, soaps are biodegradable. It means that it is not harmful for the nature. Some detergents are not biodegradable. It means some detergent can harm our nature. Okay, and soaps take more time to dissolve in water, but detergent take less time as compared to soaps to dissolve in water. And if the surface tension of water will become less, then the cloth will clean faster. So detergent will help to decrease the surface tension of water. That's why it will dissolve in water faster and clean the cloth faster. But when we dissolve soap in water, then the surface tension of water will not become as less as when we add the detergent to it. So when we add detergent to water, it will help to wash the cloth faster. Okay, and the example of soaps are sodium stearate, sodium palmitate, and the detergent are sodium dodecyl benzene sulfonate. Okay, now you can take a screenshot. So students, if you like our videos, then don't forget to subscribe, like and comment.
Subscribe कीजिए आयोगा इंस्टीट्यूट चैनल को और प्रेस कीजिए बेल आइकन को ताकि आपको मिल सके हमारा लेटेस्ट वीडियो सबसे पहले, और ये बिल्कुल फ्री है.